Welcome to the Towerside Innovation District. My name is Abby Moore from the Mississippi Watershed Management Organization, and I'm here today with Nathan Campo from Barr Engineering to take you through the Towerside Stormwater Management System, which is actually a district system, which is an innovative approach to managing stormwater. Towerside is located along the transit line between downtown Minneapolis and downtown St. Paul, just east of the University of Minnesota campus. It's a really high density development that has just come up in the last decade or so. It's about a 370 acre district that makes up this area, and it strives to be a model for sustainable urban redevelopment.
My name is Nathan Campo. I'm with Barr Engineering, and I'm one of the designers of the Towerside District Stormwater Management System. And I'm standing where it all begins, in the middle of our watershed. We have 8 acres of redevelopment representing 4 new housing projects that have gone in that are all connected to the Towerside District Stormwater Management System. Stormwater runs off of the buildings, parking lot, sidewalks, and landscaping, and makes its way towards 2 biofiltration basins where the water is then treated.
So here we are in this beautiful Stormwater Park. This is a really beautiful space and an amenity for the community around us. And it also is a large biofiltration basin. So stormwater from the 4 adjacent properties ultimately is sent to this space where it percolates through the soil and into the 200,000 gallon concrete storage tanks underneath. You can see the inlet structure right behind me. That's attached to the pipe network from the 3 properties that drain directly into this basin. And then there's also the smaller stormwater basin that drains one of the other properties, and that water is sent directly into the tank from that space.
I'm standing on a path in the middle of the stormwater basin where people can walk through Stormwater Park through the middle of the biofiltration basin when there's not water standing in the basin. But after a rain event, like Abby said, the basin fills up with water, about 1.5 feet of water, that is then filtered through the media and the sand trench, collected in under drains that then take that filtered stormwater into the tank that is directly underneath me. If we get a rain event that's larger than 1 inch, roughly, that water then overflows the system through overflow structures that are directly behind me that also serve as stepping stones and connect 2 different parts of the path. Once the water is in the tank and it's needed for the reuse system, a pump in a wet well then takes that filtered water from the tank, pumps it into the building with the treatment skid, where it's then treated and then distributed.
Here we are on the property that's just adjacent to the Stormwater Park. This is a community garden, and then over to my right, there's actually a turf space. This is all Minneapolis Park and Recreation Board land, and through a partnership between the MWMO and the Park and Recreation Board, we actually developed a UV treatment system that treats the water that comes from the storage tanks and then can be used to irrigate vegetable gardens here in the community garden, as well as the lawn next to me. This provides a really great community amenity for this really high density area. It's a great place to be outdoors. It's also a great place for community gathering. And as you can see around me right now, the community garden is looking great, and we're right at the height of growing season here. So operations and maintenance of a site like this is something that we're learning a lot about. The Mississippi Watershed Management Organization has taken responsibility for the first 5 years of O&M of the site. This allows us the opportunity to learn a lot about it during the establishment period, and also to be able to hand over this information to the Towerside Innovation District at the end of the growing season of 2022, when our 5-year contract expires. O&M and really the maintenance and inspections of the site include making sure that the inlet structure and the pretreatment are working properly, also checking the biofiltration basin, the vegetation, the status of it. We do have a contractor who is coming in periodically through the growing season to make sure that vegetation is doing well and is replaced as necessary, checking for erosion and other things going on the surface so that we understand also what might be going on underground. O&M for the tank underneath is also just making sure that everything looks good on the surface, and in theory, that should be staying really clean because all the water is pre-treated before it goes in. Thank you so much for joining us today for our tour of the Towerside District Stormwater System. And now we're happy to answer your questions.